optionally convertible debt, etc., besides the subordinated debt product. And we feel that the introduction of this quasi-equity type of product would help the MSMEs to leverage the additional equity and meet their growth requirements through additional debt funding from banks and other institutions. I think one of the areas for fast-growing MSMEs today is the option of looking at green financing. This is an option which is gaining momentum. International institutions across the world are raising funds for green development. For example, the total investment of the World Bank in green bonds has surpassed $1 billion. Similarly, many of the developing countries are today promoting green mutual funds which invest in companies whose activities, projects and investments are beneficial or supportive for the environment instead of ruining the environment or causing the problems related to pollution. These concepts have started gaining momentum in India also. And realizing the need of taking the first step to foster investment by MSMEs in the energy efficient technologies and cleaner production measures, SIDBI has raised funds from various international sources like the World Bank, Japan International Cooperation Agency, and KfW of Germany, and a World Bank line of credit, which is being channelized to the MSMEs at very, very competitive rates, ranging between 9.5 to 10% on an average, provided they go in for energy efficiency related measures. One of the major areas which needs to be scaled up further, I think, is the area of bills discounting. The bill discounting facility currently is available through banks, and in order to scale up this instrument and provide quicker and timely assistance to MSMEs, SIDBI, along with the National Stock Exchange, has taken the initiative for setting up an electronic platform for discounting of MSME receivables called Entries, that is the NSE Trade Receivable Engine for e-discounting in coordination with SIDBI. And this would discount the trade receivables on a real-time basis under the RTGS, basically, under SIDBI's receivable finance scheme, and gradually we intend to extend this to all the other banks. The idea is that ultimately the MSMEs could find the bank through this platform, which would lend to them also at the most competitive rates. So it would be a price discovery mechanism also. And as part of these initiatives, we have, through our associate institutions, MERA, the SME rating agency, which incidentally has rated more than 7,000 MSMEs, we have launched a green rating as part of our commitment to sustainable development. Green rating assesses the compatibility of an industrial unit to adhere to manufacturing processes along with efficient use of resources with minimum environmental damage. It also takes into account compliance of environmental regulatory norms by MSMEs. And to encourage the MSMEs to go in for a green rating, SIDBI has already announced a 50 basis point concession in its interest rates for units which go in for the green rating and get a reasonably good rating. I think another area I'd just like to touch upon is that realizing the need for technology financing. When we talk of fast growing MSMEs, technology financing is obviously going to be the need of the hour. SIDBI has not only floated along with other PSU banks a technology bank for non-financial options like helping the MSMEs to get the appropriate technology to do matchmaking in technology, but have also taken a lead towards technology financing as well as syndication for technology financing to the technology bank. SIDBI has been a nodal agency for the Government of India under the various technology upgradation schemes also. And today we are working on programmatic CDM and creating green funds through our technology bank. I think very briefly I thought I'd touch upon these areas, that these are some of the emerging areas of financing for the fast growing MSMEs. But equally well, what I have put in perspective earlier, that the MSME is not only the fast growing at the upper end, but the MSMEs at the bottom of the pyramid also We need to look at that. From SIDBI side, of course, we address those problems through our microcredit scheme at the lowest end, and then a micro enterprise scheme. Today we have 150 microfinance institutions as our partner, through whom we have lent out almost 4,800 crore rupees to the bottom of the pyramid segment. I think, having touched upon this, in conclusion, I'd like to say that perhaps we have MSMEs in future have to look at lean manufacturing practices, what we call 5S, Kaizen events, etc., etc., have to learn to incorporate the latest technologies, particularly the green technologies. What was mentioned in the earlier session, the use of IT and the figures which were given about websites were really surprising to me also, that maybe just perhaps 100,000 odd units have a website, because it is such a potential tool for even for particularly for marketing, which is the biggest problem area of the MSMEs. Diversification of export markets, and ultimately it's the industry associations like FISME which would have to support all these initiatives of the MSMEs by strengthening the information and knowledge base, in which there's a very, very substantial gap today, helping in perhaps common branding, consortium marketing, and other areas which ILFS had brought out in the earlier presentation. I think with these opening remarks, I would like to invite the panelists now to come and make their respective presentations. I think we start with the other people. We have Mr. Jasjit Singh Anand, the Vice President Corporate Finance of Aditya Birla Finance. I think the Aditya Birla Group needs absolutely no introduction, except to say that Mr. Anand in Aditya Birla Finance is looking after, is part of the financial services group of Aditya Birla, looking after a lot of innovative solutions for SMEs and the mid corporates. And also they do a lot of work with the Aditya Birla ecosystem, particularly the vendors and the entire value chain. May I request you to kindly nominate.